What's going on, guys? What the Flame here. And today's a sad day for Hollywood, for America, and for the rest of the world. About 20 minutes ago, I got a notification from Flipboard. And for those of you that don't know what Flipboard is, it is an application on my phone. By the way, I use a Samsung Galaxy S4, so now you guys know what phone I use. But anyways, that's not the point. The point is, what Flipboard is, it's like an all-in-one type of news application that not only talks about life news and world news and all that stuff, but it also talks about news about different subjects, such as they have a section for beauty news, they have a section for technology news, section for gaming, for cooking, for food, all that kind of stuff. It's like an all-in-one news application, kind of similar to like CNN or Fox News, but except Fox News tends to mostly lie to their people and such, so. But anyways, it's a great application. I use it to mainly look up gaming news, sometimes cooking, and a little bit of world news when I get bored. But anyways, back to the real thing. So I get the notification from Flipboard 20 minutes ago. And so, first I turn on my phone. And then I swipe down from the top. It brings my notifications menu up. And then I look for the Flipboard notification. And when I go to find it, it says Flipboard, shows a logo, and then it shows the subject right under. The subject said, Remembering Robin Williams, 1951 to 2014. And honestly, my first thoughts were, this gotta be a joke, right? I mean, there's no way that Robin Williams could be dead. I mean, this is a joke, right? I mean, there's no way. I mean, he can't be dead. He's too soon. It's just too soon. He can't be dead now. Can it? And then I go to tap on the notification. It takes me to the Flipboard application and to the main page where it says Robin Williams dead. In big letters, Robin Williams dead. And it's actually true, Robin Williams is dead. So, but I didn't read the whole news section on this thing on Flipboard, but it showed like a little link that goes to like to the CNN homepage. So I go to click on that, and it takes me to the homepage where in the breaking news section, it clearly says right there, Robin Williams is dead. And this just happened. So that's why it's breaking news. So I already have the webpage up, so give me a sec, let me bring it up. Okay. But ignore that Steam notification. Anyways, here we go. CNN Entertainment. Robin Williams dead. Family, friends, and fans are totally devastated. Uploaded 9:50 p.m. It is currently about almost 11:30. So this was about a little more than an hour ago. But yeah, it talks about the whole news, like about Robin Williams passing away. And the reason that happened is because, as I found out, Robin Williams was actually in total devastation. Like, he was in serious depression. Like, probably like you wouldn't believe. So yeah, Oscar-winning actor and comedian Robert Williams apparently took his own life at his Northern California home Monday. Law enforcement officials said Williams was 63. So I guess his birthday just passed this year. That's sad. He has been battling severe depression of late. His media representative, Martin Weston, told the internet, "This is a tragic and sudden loss. The family respectfully asks for their privacy as they grieve during this very difficult time." And I just want to say, my heart goes out to the family. I mean, being personally, I did not know Robin Williams, not personally, like, in real life, but I have watched his movies, and they did actually make me laugh. And for those fans that were fans of Robin Williams, I mean, it has to have touched their hearts too. I mean, they even show like a little video over here that even talks about it. So anyways, what else to say here? Coroner investigators suspect the death to be a suicide due to asphyxia. Not really too sure what that is, but I'm guessing that could be something bad. According to a statement from the Maine County Sheriff's Office, Williams Mary, graphic designer Susan Schneider, Napa Valley, California, ceremony in October 2001. Now, I watched a video, and according to this, it says that when he was married, this was actually the third wife that Robin Williams has married. So, this morning I lost my husband and my best friend, while the world lost one of his most beloved artists and beautiful human beings. I am utterly heartbroken. And basically, I'm not going to go into full detail on this, but the full story is on CNN.com. Of course, I'm going to put the link in the description. So, you look at this. Even Barack Obama went to say a few words for Robin Williams. Let's see. Robin Williams was an airman, a doctor, a genie, a nanny, a president, a professor, a bangarang Peter Pan, and everything in between. That is so true right there. That is so freaking true. But he was one of a kind. He arrived in our lives as an alien, but he ended up touching every element of the human spirit. He made us laugh. He made us cry. He gave us immeasurable talent freely and generously to those who needed it most. From our troops stationed abroad to the marginalized in our on our own streets. Words coming from the president himself. Anyways, Steve Martin, another actor I know that I've watched his movies and I enjoyed as well. Anyways, he did a little tweet, said, "I could not be more stunned by the loss of Robin Williams. Mensch, great talent, acting partner, genuine soul." And then stuff goes on with like Larry King, said we'll remember Williams as a genuine, caring guy, not just a funny man, but a guy who cared about people. And Williams was pronounced dead at 12:02 p.m. So this is what they were saying, that this happened at around noon, and about half a day later, almost half a day later, article came up. So Williams was last seen alive at his home where he lives with his wife at about 10 p.m. Sunday. Yesterday, okay. And yeah, that basically talks about the whole thing with Robin Williams. By the way, this is the third Night at the Museum movie that, of course, Robin Williams was going to be in. I'm not sure how many lines that he managed to get into this before he passed. I'm not sure if the movie was complete before this was made. But, yeah, but this movie is scheduled to come out around Christmas, so around December. And I also have a link to the IMDb, so to see like what Williams starred in, as in movies and TV shows. He also starred in TV shows, by the way. So, but yeah. Anyways, here we go. Robin Williams, 1951-2014. Born in Chicago, Illinois, great-great-grandson of Mississippi Governor and Senator Anselm J. McLaurin. Robin believed he studied his hands before enrolling at Juilliard School to study theater. After he left Juilliard to perform in nightclubs, where he was discovered for the role of Mork on an... I'm just going to read this last sentence, then we'll get back to it. Rolf Mork on an episode of Happy Days. I've only watched a few episodes of this TV show. I don't think I saw Robin Williams in this show yet. Keep in mind, I only watched a few episodes of this. But anyway, a subsequent spinoff, Mork and Mindy. I have not watched that show yet, but he's on television and a great deal of realization in the footsteps of his idol, Jonathan Winters. He was also proven to be an effective dramatic actor and received an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor in Good Will Hunting. I've heard about the movie, but I have not seen it yet. So, anyways, back to the main page. So yeah, this is him. And here we go. From his latest to his earliest, you see his some of his roles that he played in during, like, I guess, in some of the movies. These are all movies or TV shows, I don't know, but here we go. Here's Absolutely Anything, which is scheduled to be coming out next year, according to this. Night at the Museum, Secrets of the Tomb, once again, December of this year. Merry Freaking Christmas. I have not heard about this one, but it's scheduled to come out this sometime this year, so... Anyways, let's take a look at the other ones. I remembered, oh yeah, Louis. Louis, the TV series, I know, I haven't watched it. Wilfred, another series I've known, but I've never watched. Happy Feet 2, I didn't watch the movie, but he stars as that. I have watched Happy Feet 1, and he does play Ramon. So, Night in the Museum, I remember that one. Old Dogs. License to Wed. Night in the Museum 1. Happy Feet, Man of the Year. Everyone's Hero, RV. I remember watching this a few times, but that was it. Robots, I remember watching when this was... I remember watching this... as it was released in theater, so I remember watching this when I was 10, so, and he did play as Fender, so, at that time I didn't know he played that role, so, what else, he played in AI, which, Nostalgia Critic did a review of that one, but I didn't watch the movie yet. Patch Adams, Good Will Hunting, Flubber, he starred as the professor for that one, as you can see. I remember that movie. I guess he did play a role in Friends. Aladdin, he played in the Aladdin movies, Lion King of Thieves. I guess this was only like a home video, type movie. I don't think it went into theaters. Jumanji, I remembered, yeah. Aladdin on Ice? I don't think I remembered that one. No. Search of Dr. Seuss, okay. Mrs. Doubtfire. Aladdin, I'm very familiar with this one. I grew up as a child watching this movie. I loved it. I've loved the, A Whole New World, the, in-movie, sing-along, and the one at the end. I especially loved the one at the end with, Piabo Bryson and Regina Bell. Oh my god. That was freaking amazing. Fern Gully, The Last Rainforest, he played as that bat, as you can see. See here, Batty. It's a cute little fella here. What else? also played as Hook. I have not watched the movie, but I don't think I've heard of the movie either. But yeah, that'll probably be on one of my list of movies to watch. Anyways, Dead Poets Society. What else do I know? Was there something else? That was Aladdin. There was Hook. Oh yeah, Popeye. Yeah, Popeye. I remember that one. And this is actually the realistic movie that came out during like 1980, when Robin Williams was like really, really young. He was like at around. He was like he was actually either 28 or 29 when he was playing it, so you can imagine how young he was. So, man, Happy Days, Richard Pryor Show, and it looks like this was the first one, the first piece of I guess it was a TV show or a movie that he watched, that he starred in. Can I Do It Till I Need Glasses? 1977. So yeah, there was a lot of stuff that he starred in, both movies and TV shows. So that's pretty amazing right there. Anyways, let me get out of this. Okay, now you can see my beautiful face again. But yeah, anyways, that's just a little bit of a biography, filmography, and a little bit of the life of Robin Williams. And it's a tragic shame that he passed so soon. I mean, especially not because of like diseases or stuff like that, even though it mentioned during the CNN video during the mid to late 2000s. He went to like hospitals for the treatment of like a couple of diseases, and especially I think it was like in 09 they was treated for like a heart disease or something like that. So that's gotta be pretty awful for the guy. But I mean, yeah. Anyways, that's Robin Williams. I'm pretty sure he will be missed dearly by Hollywood, by mainly his family. Also, by America, by people around the world, to his fans, and especially myself. Tragic shame that we lost in the Hollywood department. Another star has gone off to heaven, as they say. And Robin Williams, may you forever be in our hearts. Thank you guys for watching this little tribute thing I decided to do for like Robin Williams, because personally I feel this guy was a great guy and he helped entertain the world. He helped make them laugh. He made them cry. I mean, he helped us so much by bringing joy and happiness to his acting, do his big screen performance and all that stuff, and he will be forever missed, along with other Hollywood stars such as Tony Gandolfini, or no, what's his name? Actually, this is something Gandolfini. Anyways, he starred in the Sopranos. I think James Gandolfini. Yeah, James Gandolfini. He was Mr. Soprano in The Sopranos. Who else? Anyways, Robin Williams is gonna be right up there with the stars and all that. So, thank you guys for watching this little tribute to Robin Williams, and my heart goes out to the family and to all the fans that are like that have watched his watched his movies and his TV shows and all that, but mainly to his family, who are probably having like a very hard time right now, and I'm just sorry. My heart goes out to you guys. That's it. So, anyways, thank you guys for watching. I hope this has been informative and helpful, and that's it. And I'm going to leave you guys with a little sideshow tribute dedicated to the one and only Robin Williams. A loving comedian, a loving actor, a loving father, a loving man of many people. Thank you guys for watching, and good night. Peace out. Rest in peace, Robin Williams, and my heart goes out to the family. Thank you.
How can I convince you what you see is real? Who am I to blame you for doubting what you feel? I was always reaching, you were just a girl. I knew I took for granted the friend I have in you. I was living for a dream, loving for a moment, taking on the just my style. Now I look into your eyes, I can see forever. The search is over, you were with me all the while. Can we last forever? Will we fall apart? At times it's so confusing, the questions of the heart. You followed me through changes, and patiently you'd wait till I came to my senses through some miracle of fate. I was living for a dream, loving for a moment, right before my